Hello, everyone. My name is Eliyahu Yehuda. I'm the CTO and co-founder of Zimperium, a security company located in Israel, established at 2011 by myself and Yitzhak Avraham. Zimperium is specializing in mobile security. We also won last Calculist mobile contest for 2013. Okay, let's start talking about mobile evolution. We all witnessed how the mobile device evolved from a simple device used to communicate, make and receive phone calls, to a much more powerful device, actually equivalent, if not more powerful, than our personal computer. We actually use our mobile device in much more manners than we use our personal computer for. Sorry. Can you take the... Sorry. Okay. We use our mobile device to access our personal data, social media, use it to enter our Facebook, make bank transactions, use it for our private photographs and so on. Many of us also use the mobile device to access our network, our organization network. From there, we have access to sensitive data, things we would like to keep confidential, obviously. Now, we all been aware of mobile popularity. I'm sure any of you have at least one mobile device in your pocket. And currently, we're talking about 5.5 billion devices worldwide. And expected growth in 2016 is 135%. Something is no new to any of you, I'm sure. What is not so known to many of us, however, is this tsunami malware increase, as you can clearly see. In 2012, the earth shook. We had a earthquake of malware increase. Right now, we should be expecting the malware tsunami wave should be hitting us every second now. Now, what are the methods used by an attacker to access our device? In the name of accessibility, the mobile device allows much more methods to access our device, but this comes at a price of security. Now, all these channels, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, 3G, NFC, are all basically lucrative channels for an attacker to access our device. Even NFC, which is considered a security protocol, was hacked several months ago in the United States, very successfully. Now, what's the implications of such an attack? Well, all this information, which we described earlier, whether it's private or organizational, now is in the hands of the attacker through our mobile device. We basically allow him the access. Now, I should mention that once the attacker has access through our device to our organizational network, all the organizational network has also been compromised. Now, current methods we are all aware of are virtualization, antivirus, firewall. Virtualization never pretends to be a security layer, and firewall and antivirus, each of them only protects against one layer only. And both of them, as you all may know, use static and old methods to determine the threats. Zimperium, which as I described, a security company, detected the need for such a solution on the mobile platform, and we have presented the Zico IPS, the next generation security suite for the mobile platform. Zico Intrusion Prevention System is the world's first mobile intrusion prevention system. Zico prevents threats from entering the system using a behavior recognition system which integrates artificial intelligence to detect and classify the behavior of each and every task in the system in real time to malicious or non-malicious according to its behavior. Now, the Zico IPS itself runs locally on the device and communicates via the cloud and communicates with our Z Appliance solution, which is our MDM solution. Z Appliance is our complete mobile device governance solution. It's a management console, integrates device provisioning, generating detailed reports, control security, state of the devices, and so on. The Zico IPS itself protects against three layers of attack: local attacks, network attacks, and targeted attacks. Local attack is what we are all familiar with as viruses, exploits, and so on. It's when we download an innocent-looking application for the market, and inside it embeds itself a nice-looking virus without the user knowing, takes control over the device, and finito la commedia. Now, only a few months ago, 3 million devices were affected by such a virus. Google took it off the market. Obviously, there were a time period where 3 million devices were compromised. Network attacks is the time it takes any of us to enter Starbucks and ask for a coffee is enough time for any hacker to access the Wi-Fi network, redirect data to and from the device, and even take control of our device before we put sugar in our coffee. Targeted attacks is what we refer to as crafted attacks. Again, a specific person, usually a decision maker, CEO, prime minister, and such. When they get a crafted email or an SMS with a URL or a document or anything which might contain a zero-day exploit and something like that, which again takes control of the device without the user knowing. Zico IPS protects and prevents all of those three attacks. Thank you very much for your time, and let's secure the world together, shall we? Thanks.